is it okay if I talk to you a little bit?
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
So, tell me your story.
Okay, wow. I've never really been asked that. I went through a divorce when I was 25, and I had never done drugs or drank or anything. And, I mean, I'd always been an at-home mom and just a wife, you know, and like I got to the point where, like, whenever my husband took my kid, you know, took the kids and everything, because I was in jail, you know, at the time, you know, for I guess beating up the woman that was trying to interfere in our, you know, our marriage. And I remember my mom, you know, going and saying, you know, stop looking out the window and stop waiting, you know, for something to change. You know, you got to get out there and do it yourself. And I walked out the door, dude, and she said, this will make you feel better. And I remember her handing me a 40 and you know, of an alcohol and shit. And I mean, I remember puking my guts up like real hardcore, and then after that, dude, I was hooked. And like my alcohol habit like went like through the roof. And I mean that's all I did was, you know, drink on a daily basis. And it got to the point where, I mean, I didn't want to work. I didn't want to like function like with society or anything, dude. I mean, I just wanted to stick to myself. And like the only way I could think to do it, dude, was to actually just put a backpack on of whatever I could find, you know, and just start jumping trains, you know. And I traveled 11 states in 11 months.
That's actually cool.
Yeah, I know. I saw a bunch of cool stuff. I hitchhiked. I flew signs. A lot of people, thank God, helped me, you know, with food and like with warmth and stuff, because some of the states I went to, like Montana and Colorado, were pretty cold. And there was churches that helped me out extremely. And I don't know, I mean, just like off and on, you know, for 7 years I was homeless, you know. And then finally I started getting my children back in my life and like doing the right thing and everything. And as soon as I was doing the right thing again, you know, and I slowed down my drinking, I took a ride with my uncle, and I guess he had some kind of dope baggie or whatever in his car, and I took the charge for him, you know, thinking that it was just going to be probation. You know, well, I didn't know that you can't drink on probation, so I screwed myself on that. And I just now got done doing 2 years, and I just now got out like 3 months ago. And I've been staying at a friend's house, but in a garage that has pretty much no roof, no siding or nothing, you know, like where you wake up and your face is swollen from mosquito bites kind of stuff. And I'm like, dude, I mean, if I can live there, dude, I mean, I might as well just live out here, you know.
So as far as living out here, do you enjoy it? Have you gotten used to it? Are you wishing you could be out? Are you just at the point where you don't care anymore?
No, I would love to change my life, because I mean, especially being a female, dude. I mean, like, I'm a strong female, though. You know what I'm saying? But I mean, even the strongest, you know, can become weak at, you know, at a point, you know, where you haven't been able to take a shower and, you know, a couple of days, and you feel gross about yourself, especially being a, you know, a woman. You know, you feel down and out and disgusted, and you take baths in a creek like that. You know, I mean, that's not sanitary. You know, and then you just start looking down on yourself and not feeling good about yourself, and you know, I mean, and then you start having like suicidal thoughts and shit. And I mean, that's all your life becomes.
On the suicide, what would that solve, you think?
I guess you wouldn't have to wake up alone to this shit no more, you know.
But at least you'd be waking up if you didn't do it.
Yeah.
As long as you stay alive, there's always a chance. So what plans do you have?
Well, other than crying right now like a little bitch. Just getting the hell out of this mess, you know what I mean? I'm not talking about this area in general. I mean, I love my friends. But and my friends are badass people, dude, and they're really strong motherfuckers. And they've done this for years and years on end, dude, like constantly on a daily basis. I mean, I fortunately get to have like one place a week, you know, that I can actually go that has like a fan or an air conditioner, you know. And and I'm very blessed for that, you know. So, and I have like a ton of friends, you know, that are like always trying to keep their door open. It's just that I don't want to wear my welcome out, you know.
Yeah.
And since I'm a drinker, and I'm a violent drinker, then I mean, I stay there as long as I can until I get that attitude, then I'm out, you know.
So what thoughts have you had on trying to get off the streets?
The way I see it, there's like only three ways for a woman to make it out here, and that's to either sell drugs, sell your ass, or fly a sign. I fly a sign, you know what I'm saying?
That sounds like the better of the three.
Yeah, I know, right?
Probably a little bit safer.
I'd rather hold up this cardboard any day, dude, than spread my legs, dude. And selling dope, dude, will just get you time, so. And it's just not the way to go. And I'm not gonna hold on to something I don't do. I can't sell you alcohol because I'm gonna drink it.
Yeah.
I've been drinking the product. I've never making money.
So what's your name?
My name's Holly.
Holly? I'm John.
Hi.
Sorry I didn't tell you when I first came up.
Oh, that's right. It's cool.
So you live on the other side of the same creek. So how have you actually survived out here with, and I'm talking about like the basic necessities. Like food, water, showering, clothing.
As much as I could probably stress it, and see, it's weird because I'm not even a believer in God, but it's because of God that I've made it, because, churches, they give you, food on Mondays and Thursdays, you know, and then, like, even after services, you can talk to preachers and stuff, and, you know, there's so many good people willing to help you, you know what I'm saying, if you want that help, you know, but you got to go out there and get it, you know, and, like my friends, you know, like, having that initiative to get up in the morning, dude, and, like, go get the water and go get, you know, like, the soap and stuff like that, you know, from other friends or something that are helping them out, you know, and just, like, helping about in the community of the homeless, you know what I'm saying? You know, like, it's not just one of us that's homeless. It's all of us that are homeless, you know?
Yeah.
So if he's got a bag of soap, he's going to distribute it out to the rest of us, you know? And we must, you know, we show much love and appreciation for it.
How about basic survival if you don't have your friends there to help?
If I show you where I stay, dude, you'd be like, oh my God, because like they have tents, they have a bridge, you know. I have three trees, and I have a blanket over one side, and I have a little plastic banner on the top of me, and like I just pretty much hope for the best, you know. I don't even got a sleeping bag.
You don't even have a sleeping bag? What do you actually sleep with?
I just little sheets like this. I mean, this is all I could find. I just put it on the ground and that's it.
So what do you do in the winter months?
I've been locked up, dude, for the past 2 years, but before that, going into store, 24-hour stores, going into like 24-hour restaurants, going to sleep in the bathrooms and stuff, you know, they don't know. It's not like they're checking. Really.
Have you ever been thrown out of any place? Like, have they caught you?
I'm not dogging Jack in the Box. I love Jack in the Box, but yeah, I mean, they are like, you know, they're like a cleaner facility, and they will, they will check the bathrooms, I'm telling you that much. And they frown on the point of sleeping right there, and you know, the handicapped bathroom, it's got extra room, you know what I'm saying? So, there's some restaurants, dude, like the Waffle House and like some of the other little cafes and stuff, dude. They'll see you, and they'll wake you up and let you know something. And, you know, just,
so some of them are good people.
Yeah.
Help out.
Well, it's not the Jack Box any good. There's some places that'll warn you, like let you actually post up for a minute and they're due to get warm, and then you have to move around, you know, because the customers and the facility, you know, like rules and shit like that. But that's all right.